Calendar number 133 by Senator Squadron. Senate print, 6141B, an act to amend the environmental conservation law.
Explanation has been requested. Senator Squadron.
Mr. President, this bill would create a would put on the table for the first time in the nation a gallons per mile standard for consumers to make use of when considering what car to purchase. Gallons per mile is a much better standard than miles per gallon for consumers who are conscious about the effect on the environment or the effect on their wallets of different cars they might be choosing and trying to find the more efficient, the most efficient one. It does so with a very modest requirement that every auto dealer selling new cars put up a single poster in the auto dealership that explains the gallons per mile relative to miles per gallon and to the amount of relative savings at increments of 5 miles per gallon from 5 to 50 for each level, so that you can really see that, for example, you're much better off going from a car, if you're choosing between a car that goes 10 miles per gallon and 15, you save a lot more gas over 1,000 miles than if you take a car from 25 to 45 miles per gallon. Gallons per mile has been shown in studies to really drive consumers to choose vehicles that use less gas. Less gas is great for the environment and great for wallets. This bill will put New York on the cutting edge of how to really think about fuel efficiency in the 21st century. It's great for the 40th Earth Day that we are going to be starting to think about how we consider fuel efficiency and making good choices on fuel efficiency for the next 100 Earth Days.
Thank you, Senator Squadron. Senator DeFrancisco.
Would Senator Squadron
Excuse
yield?
Excuse me, Senator DeFrancisco. Can we have some quiet, please?
Would Thank Senator you. Squadron please yield to a question?
Do you yield to a question, Senator Squadron, from Senator DeFrancisco? You may proceed.
Can you tell me what additional information a consumer gets by learning the gallons per mile versus miles per gallon?
Senator Squadron.
Well, comparatively, when you have the gallons per mile number in front of you, what you learn is the relative gallon per mile of that gallon per 1,000 miles, in the case of this bill, of different vehicles. You don't have that miles per gallon standard. It is a relatively simple calculation, but it's not one that consumers normally do, and it's frankly the gallon per mile standard isn't one that most consumers are aware of. So I'd say the other thing they learn through this bill is about the gallons per mile standard and why it's so important.
Senator DeFrancisco.
Would Senator Squadron answer another question?
Would you continue to yield, Senator Squadron, through
yes,
if
the President?
If I know the miles per gallon, are you saying we get additional information if you require a signage reversing that as the gallons per mile? What additional information do we get?
Through you, Mr.
Easily,
President.
Can't you easily convert that by a simple mathematical formula?
Senator Squadron.
Through you, Mr. President, and someone had mentioned that it was the inverse. This bill, the information that you get out of this bill is twofold. First, you get the existence of the gallons per mile standard and why it's so important. And secondly, you do get a nice side-by-side comparison of miles per gallon, gallons per 1,000 miles, in fact, and the relative savings as you sort of climb the ladder on miles per gallon. So it is information that would be available to a savvy consumer who was considering it. But as we well know, gallons per mile is probably a new concept to most people in this room today.
Senator DeFrancisco.
I'd just like to speak on the bill.
Senator DeFrancisco on the bill.
I think I just discovered the reason why no other state has this bill. Every new car in every dealership posts miles per gallon. And it's a simple conversion of numbers to make a simple calculation as to what gallons per mile are. We're going to require our auto dealers in our state to be less competitive to talk about gallons per mile rather than miles per gallon when the federal government already requires this disclosure. It's on every place. In addition, this bill, believe it or not, I didn't ask about this. I was afraid of the answer, because you have to also post The cost of fuel per 1,000 miles based upon the most recent United States Environmental Protection Agency's fuel economy guide price of gas. Guide price of gas. So I guess the dealer's going to have to go out periodically, see what the price of gas is, put up all new signs, and if you don't have the sign up, you get a free pass the first time, then it's a $100 fine per car. I mean, are we trying to be business unfriendly? There is absolutely no additional value to what is being required to be provided by our auto dealers than any other auto dealers. This is not, does nothing for the environment. It does a lot for making our auto dealers non-competitive. I urge a unanimous no vote.
Senator DeFrancisco, thank you, Senator DeFrancisco. You will be required in the negative. Senator Fraschillo, to explain his vote
on the bill.
Excuse me.
Would the sponsor yield for a few questions?
Yield for questions.
I'd be happy to.
Senator Squadron, this is for every model that the dealership would have. If they have 10 different models, they have to post 10 different signs?
Through you, Mr. President. No, it's not. A couple of points of fact. On the previous speaker, very briefly. There's a standard EPA, comes out annually, it says based on, so it wouldn't have to be exactly what it is if there were slight shifts, so it wouldn't have to be sort of regularly putting up new posters. It's a $50 fine the second time, not a $100 fine. But to answer this question, no, it's a single poster, and in fact, the legislation would require DEC to create a model poster that would be exactly what you would use. It would be posted on the website and could therefore be printed out by any of the dealers. It would be a single standard one based on, as I say, miles per gallon increments of 5 from 5 to 50.
Would the sponsor yield for one question?
We continue to yield, Senator Squadron.
Yes.
You may proceed, Senator.
Senator, one of the things that concerns me is the way it's written, the bill. You just said the DEC, but in the legislation, you write, the department shall develop a model sign which provides consumer fuel consumption information. Nowhere in the bill do you reference what department. Now, I've read this bill multiple times, and I don't know if it's the Department of Consumer Protection, Environmental Conservation, or DEC, because if this becomes law, the law will not specify which department has the responsibility to do exactly what you're asking them to do.
President, in answer to that question, this language was crafted in coordination with DEC. It exists in Section 3 of the Environmental Conservation Law, which is the section that lays out the responsibilities of the commissioner of DEC.
Senator Frischel.
Thank you, Senator.
Senator Larkin, on the bill.
Would Senator Squadron respond to one question?
Yield for one question from Senator Larkin.
I will yield for one to begin and then a second if needed.
Daniel, who's going to hire all these inspectors to see that this is done?
Senator Squadron.
Through you, Mr. President, there are, as I'm sure many of the senators in the room know, any number of requirements put on auto dealers and others in the state of New York, some, in fact, under the ECL that have to do with auto dealers, and presumably this would be enforced the way other laws are enforced.
Senator Larkin.
On the bill.
On the bill, Senator Larkin.
You know, every one of us have automobile dealers. I hope you've all gone home and asked them about this. And one fella said to me, are you crazy? We're having a hard time selling cars as it is. Why don't you stop punishing us? Gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, think of what you did yesterday. You stuck a knife into the contractors and cut them loose. A few minutes ago, we wanted to cut out the industry for jobs. And I hear this from Washington to here, jobs, jobs, job. What we ought to be starting saying is, how much can we do to you so we'll get you to move out of New York? When are we going to wake up and start to remember that this is our state? As we look at it, everybody's looking at us as a bunch of jerks. You know what they said? Dan, just for information, they said, why don't you guys sit down and do the budget instead of the nonsense?
Are there any other senators wishing to be heard? Hearing none, the debate is closed. The secretary will ring the bells. Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect on the 1st of January next succeeding.
Call the roll.
Adams, Espada, Krueger, Skelos, Smith, Young.
Senator Saland to explain his vote.
Mr. President, this just flies in the face of common sense. If you want to talk about extraneous, superfluous legislation, this one takes the prize. If I'm interested in buying a car and gas mileage is my concern, I don't need to figure out another way to calibrate or compute whatever it's going to be. If I want to buy a car, I look at the sticker that comes with the car, and it says so much per miles per gallon for city driving, so much for highway driving, whatever the average may be. If I'm concerned about fuel efficiency, I don't look at the model that gives me 15 miles to the gallon. I look at the model that gives me 25 to 30 miles to the gallon. Purely extraneous, superfluous, and a hardship on an already struggling industry that's been through the most difficult challenges of any industry that we have seen in our state. Mr. President, I vote in the negative.
Senator Slam will be recorded in the negative. Senator Squadron to explain his vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. You know, it's really a shame that the idea of giving consumers better information, that research that shows again and again that different kinds of information presented to consumers lead to different conclusions, is considered quite so absurd in this chamber. You know, it's sometimes said that doing something for the environment and doing something for the economy are in conflict. This bill actually proves that doing something for the environment, doing something for consumers' wallets in the state of New York, so they have the information in front of them to make better choices in purchasing, is right there for them in a way that it wouldn't be in any other state, is such a ridiculous concept in this chamber. The fact is, miles per gallon is a standard that was created many, many years ago when folks were not nearly as interested in actually comparison shopping around efficiency. When gas didn't cost nearly as much as it does today. And I think that frankly, it's only a matter of time before the gallons per mile standard is used. And I'm very pleased that as part of the Earth Day package, the Senate has taken it up today. I'll be voting yes. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Squadron. Senator Libous, excuse me, if we could see the show of hands of those voting in the negative, why Senator Libous is explaining his vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. Senator Squadron, all due respect, obviously your constituents in Brooklyn, am I correct? In Lower Manhattan, I apologize. Must take a very different approach than those in Binghamton, because if I vote for this bill, they'll run me over with their cars. I mean, we sit here on, is today the 20th? And no state budget, and if I vote for this bill and go back home and tell them I did it. Mr. President, I vote no. This is just not something that's needed.
This will be recorded in the negative. Senator DeFrancisco to explain his vote.
If this bill provided consumers more information and helped them to make an environmentally sound decision on what car to buy, I would consider voting for it. But you're getting no more information by getting gallons per mile information as opposed to miles per gallon. You compare apples to apples. You compare miles per gallon to miles per gallon, no matter what the price of the gasoline is. The only effect this has on the environment is all the placards that are going to be on the thousands and hundreds of thousands of cars in the state of New York will result in destruction of trees in the Adirondacks or someplace else. There's no additional information. It can't possibly benefit the environment, and it just puts us, our car dealers, at a competitive disadvantage. I vote no.
Senator DeFrancisco will be recorded in the negative. Senator Libous, why do you rise?
Mr. President, on the roll call, I thought members had to be in their seats for a vote. I thought that's what the rules said.
I believe that's correct, Senator Libous.
And I see a lot of empty seats in the chamber, Mr. President.
Pardon?
I see a lot of empty seats in the chamber.
Senator Libous, the vote was recorded more than 10.
If the seat is empty, I mean, the vote was closed. No, hang on, Mr. President.
We recorded the vote probably 6 or 7 minutes ago, Senator Libous.
When we first called the polls. They were empty 6 or 7 minutes ago, Mr. President.
No, there weren't.
Listen, I know the hour is late. I'm not trying to give a hard time, but the Senate rules are pretty specific that you have to be in your seat for a roll call.
Yep, duly noted, Senator Libous, and we'll enforce it for both sides.
We would appreciate if you do that, Mr. President. Thank you, and we'll be anxious to see what happens on the next vote, sir.
Thank you, Senator Libous. Announce the results.
Those recorded in the negative on calendar number 133 are Senators Alisi, Bonasek, DeFrancisco, Farley, Flanagan, Fuscillo, Golden, Griffo, Hannon, O. Johnson, Larkin, Libel, Libous, Little, Marcelino, Maziarz, McDonald, Nozzolio, Ranzenhofer, Robach, Saland, Seward, Skelos, Volker, Winner, and Young. Ayes 35, nays 26.
The bill is passed.